What is up, nerds?
So, we are here to review the 14th episode
some
of
shit.
Season 6
some
called
shit.
Page 23.
Yeah, page shit.
Why do you think it was called page 23?
Because it was about that page. It was Regina and Robin and that page that appeared to her that, you know, she tore up a while back and taped back together.
Oh.
It was about her and her happy ending.
Oh. Okay. Whatever.
Yeah.
Anyway, so...
See? Complaining that whole episode about how I wasn't paying attention. And yet I know the answer. And you don't. Suck it, nerd.
Shut up.
Get right, nerd.
Anyway, so in that... At least in that first scene, but I've noticed it throughout the episode, on and off.
I think she had a cold.
Yeah, the Evil Queen sounded off.
Yeah, that was one of my quotes. She's been quoting me.
Well, I didn't really have that many quotes. You know why? Because you weren't really paying attention. You're mostly playing your game.
Yeah, well.
This show's gotten so boring, guys. I apologize. But yeah,
I don't. You know why? Because if it were more interesting, we'd have better reviews.
Yeah, probably so. Okay, so what, you think the actress had a cold while she was filming those?
Totally.
Okay. That makes sense. Anyway, so yeah, and then Tinkerbell randomly appearing in one episode. I mean, in one episode, in one scene.
Yeah, like they must have had to dig deep to go find that actress again.
No, she's working on a CW show, which meant she's probably in Vancouver as well. You know. But yeah. Evil Queen had Robin dig in the graveyard for the damn shears of fate or
Robin
destiny.
Robin has a point, though. Why didn't she just, like, poof that shit?
Magic it up?
Yeah.
Because the writers are stupid. I don't know. Like, there was...
That was about as smart as whenever she magicked a pickaxe and then hit it one time and
it
went right 3 inches into the dirt.
Not even. But yeah, like those shears. And but yeah. So Emma went and told everyone that she's engaged. Dude, so
engaged.
Swan Queen fans are so upset about the whole Emma Regina hugging and Regina being like, "I am so happy for you," because they're like, "Man, that's like a slap in the face."
Yeah, well, whatever.
So, yeah.
Y'all should over it,
like,
unfortunately.
It was
kind of
funny.
It's been a long time coming. We all knew this was going to happen.
Yeah. I'm still sad that it's not ending in either Swanfire or Swan Queen.
I'm with you. I'm not saying
or
I'm not.
Or Swanfire Queen. Like, come on.
Hey, look. That would be an epic
threesome. That Henry would have all three of his parents.
I wonder if this, something that I don't know if she put down as a Richie quote, but.
Don't think so. I don't think I have any other Richie quotes.
How many moms can she have, can Henry have in one shot?
Yeah, how many moms, because yeah, Regina and the Evil Queen and Emma just need to split Emma in two and yeah, so many moms.
Yeah, that's dumb.
Oh, the moms.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, everyone asking Emma, how did he pop the question? Well, you see, he didn't. But yeah, I think...
Because you don't know how to not snoop through another man's shit. Way to go.
Another man? So Emma's another man?
She snooped through Neil's shit.
There she did! Ha ha!
So suck it, nerd. Ha ha.
So yeah, and Nemo and the Nautilus... We're leaving. What I want to know is, how did they even get to Storybrooke in the first place? Because wasn't there like a protection spell all around? And it doesn't just go to the land, it also goes to the water. So like, is there like a portal under the sea that you can get to various lands? I'm sorry about my hair, guys. My hair is like horrible. That's why I'm wearing this.
Retcon.
In addition to the fact that I haven't worn this. Maybe it's like mermaids.
Retcon.
Mermaids can travel from underwater, so maybe it's the same thing?
Retcon.
I don't know. Like, I was confused the whole time they're getting ready to leave. Because I'm like, how are they going to leave? There's a protection spell. This doesn't make any sense. But whatever. Anyway, and so I was kind of confused about the whole Henry can just write the Evil Queen out of existence thing. Because he's not from...
Also...
Apparently, it's because she is not from his book. But isn't his book the events that have happened? And seeing as Regina split herself in two, the Evil Queen is from his book. Because, yeah, he had to write about that happening.
Also, this whole...
So that
this whole stupid. This whole Regina thing with the hearts...
That would have been the perfect way to put them back into one. Because, yeah, they finally had Regina accept herself fully. Her goodness and her darkness. And yet they still didn't put her one in the same. No. They had the Evil Queen go off to Wish Realm.
They retconned the shit out of that. Holy crap.
Like, that was
crap.
So stupid.
That
was
like, an impressive level of dumb.
I'm like, oh, okay. Like, whenever Regina took both their hearts and one was dark and one was red and she put them together, I'm like, oh, okay, so she's going to meld them together and they're going to become one.
Their hearts were fucking.
Happy Regina. Okay, happy with herself and whole. No. They just had, like, the goodness and the evilness switching until they were equal, and then evil Regina went off to Wish Realm because that's where she'll find her happy.
But she's not evil Regina anymore. She's just EQ.
No, she's not EQ because she's no longer evil. She's just the queen.
So... Sith Lord Fox?
It's actually a wolf.
Sith Lord Wolf, right. Not far.
But yeah, like, but even. Okay, so that light magic.
Shit, so dumb.
Doo 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 doo. So Prince Henry, poor Prince Henry, is like forever trying to convince Regina to find true happiness and not just, you know, kill Snow White, because he knows that's not how she's going to find happiness. And the poor guy.
I mean, how she hates herself most.
Too bad he couldn't, you know, develop a spine whenever he was married to Cora.
Yeah. Douche prick.
Whatever. But yeah, so. Yeah, Regina hates herself the most. Surprise, surprise, Richie called it. But yeah, that random light magic archway. I'm like, what? Does it like lead to elsewhere? Nah, it leads to what? The fairies? And then they found the statue of Cupid? And that's how you find your true love, but she did something because there is a fine line between love and hate, which there's really not.
The things are polar opposites. There's really not a fine line between that at all. Also,
they're
what's
both
hilarious,
very passionate
also what's hilarious,
feelings, but it's not a close line. Trust me when I say I do not love those that I hate.
Yeah, I'm with you. Also, by the way, you know what's funny?
Hmm.
How they basically went back yet again and retconned soulmates and true loves.
Oh, they've done that a million times. It's not that surprising.
No, but it's incredibly stupid.
So that's season 6.
Yeah.
Yep.
Lexi.
Huh?
Side note, did you put more mail up there?
No.
Okay.
That's been there.
Okay.
I stopped putting it up there because you stopped looking up there.
Yeah, it probably just looks weird. Whatever.
yeah.
Off topic.
Squirrel. But yeah, so how about Emma freaking out when she discovered that Hook was about to apparently burn his memories, which is not what I thought he was about to do. I just saw him looking at the Dreamcatcher and I'm like, what is he doing? Trying to decide best how he was going to tell her. And then she automatically knew that he was going to burn the Dreamcatcher.
How did
she
know what David's father looked like?
Yeah, that too.
They've never talked about Grandpa David.
Robert. His name is Robert.
Grandpa Robert.
Like, she doesn't know what he looks like. Like, I was so confused by that. I'm like, how does she know that was him? Like, yeah, and she doesn't even mention the murder. Well, I mean, she mentioned it, but, like, she just automatically assumed that David's going to just forgive him because, you know, they just forgive everybody. Murder is no big deal. Oh, no. You're going to burn your memories. That is the worst thing.
Also, and it's what like, was okay, hilarious.
While you never met your grandpa, you realize that David has gone through his whole life thinking that his father was still a drunk even after he promised he wouldn't drink anymore and that he died in a drunken cart accident and then found out that his dad was actually murdered.
That there was a hole so big in his chest that you could see light through it.
Yeah.
But he was drunk.
Like, it's not like, you know, whenever Mila died and it was 300 years ago and there's only like two people that are still alive that remember it. No, but like,
Mila. Nobody likes Mila.
That was like, including the curse, maybe 40 years.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like,
the man I married would have known that we work things out together. What?
Okay. So yeah, she told Hook, I like paused it and took the quote. "You come to me, Hook. You lean on me and trust me. We have to stop hiding things from each other. The man I fell in love with would know that."
No, he wouldn't.
Okay, so as I put right here, "The man you fell in love with has been lying since you met, and he has not stopped. Why are you surprised?" Oh, right, because you're blissfully ignorant about a lot of the stuff that he was lying about. "Because you said it didn't matter. And then that's the man you agreed to marry?" Yeah, that man was all in your head.
Ha 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 ha.
Yeah, ha 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 ha. His four ha ha's.
Exactly.
Huh.
Ha 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 ha. That's five.
Ha 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 ha.
Okay, then why did you say ha 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 ha?
Because it sounded better.
Exactly. Maybe you should have typed it out better.
Well, I'm sorry. Shut up. I was just doing do 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 do. Okay. So like, yeah. Anyway. That.
This show's so dumb. And then she took the ring off.
And gave it back to him. And oh my goodness, what are you doing?
Good question.
My notes was acting up. Anyway, so. Yeah, moving on from that. So, whenever Regina went to her office, like, and Robin's like, "Oh, you shouldn't have come here." All I could think is, well, she works there, so shouldn't she be there?
Also,
no matter
by the way,
like,
why
do they ever
that,
do work why in was, that office anymore?
Why was that fight initially, like, initialized with swords? Like, we're like, oh, we're just gonna duel each other to death. Bitch, y'all have magic. You were never gonna do that. The fuck?
Also, Richie, how about that, how the shears cut the fate between them? Like, what was that? That was so stupid. Okay. Yeah.
Couldn't you have...
I don't know who decided that that was a good idea.
Couldn't you have just golden lined it like the fates in Hercules?
Like, you know, like a golden
golden
hair?
Thread?
No, like dramatic arms in the air. Like, YMCA. Like, what the fuck? I did not understand that at all. Anyway... But yeah, Regina still doesn't regret anything that happened because it led her to Henry. And I still say what I've been saying since season 3, and
that's
she originally
bullshit.
Said that. You can regret killing people and still be okay with it leading up to your son, okay?
I regret nothing. Really? You could have had a...
You can regret past mistakes while still being okay with where it led.
Apparently she's okay with killing all of these people and not finding Robin the first go-round whenever she had the prime opportunity to. When it was literally... When Tink literally showed her...
Yeah, what, she didn't regret that? Like, I'm sure there's a bunch of things that it would make sense for her to regret, but still be okay with her loving her son. Like, just because you regret them doesn't mean that all of a sudden, oh my god, I regret killing these people. I must hate my son.
What?
Like, I don't understand that whole, she can't regret all the things because, you know, it led to her son thing. I don't know. The thank you, Zelina, is the part where she's like, okay, so we're just going to forgive her for trying to kill everyone, and It's like,
I don't know, like half the people
did. I don't like Zelina, but a lot of the stuff that she has said over the past couple years, like season 5
and
6.
Yeah, but it's the same bullshit that's been going on with her.
Oh no, it's the same thing with her.
So don't be hypocritical, you're an idiot.
Like, I just agreed with what she said. I'm just like, yeah, that. I mean, I don't like you either for the same shit, but Zelina got a point, guys. Like, y'all need a... Y'all, wow, it looks like I have, like, a unicorn horn with an ear.
Are you feeling horny? Ja, 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 ja.
That's not horns. How it works. It's ha, 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 ha.
Yeah. Face hole. I took 3 years of Spanish, I know that. Don't care.
Yeah, anyway, so... I like the whole went to the place that she could get a fresh start thing. I'm like, wow, that's specific.
I thought they went back in time. No, it was Wish Realm.
Yeah.
Then I was depressed.
Realm. Also, you like how I wrote that sentence?
I hope TM.
Snow is giving a capital hope with a trademark symbol. Speech to Hook. We haven't seen a Snow White Hope speech in a while.
You know what I also find hilarious? Oh, she told me everything that she knows about the sleeping curse.
Oh, yeah, that.
That was your opportunity to get them together again.
It's like, wait, really? She told you everything. You couldn't just have her fix it before she left?
Yeah, like...
You had to send her away right at that time?
What kind of bullshit is this?
Like, what the fuck?
What kind of dumbass shit are we watching?
Like, I get that y'all want to have, you know, one episode dedicated to that, but storyline-wise, that's
really stupid. You're dumb as a box of rocks.
That made the characters look dumb. Or, then the show's already started making them look like all the characters have been acting out of character.
Shit.
The one thing that did make me laugh, Gideon sent Hook away.
Ha,
he's counting the ha's.
Ha 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 ha.
Was that right?
Mm-hmm.
Ha 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 ha.
See, I know how to read. Get right, nerd.
Yeah, so many ha-has.
Yeah. So, yeah, Hook's no longer around.
Oh, bold. Gideon sent Hook away. Like, I'm so happy about that. It's going to be so dramatic. Yeah, and then there's going to be angst because Emma's going to be like, oh, he left me voluntarily. And he's going to be like, oh, I meant to stay with her. And then they'll see each other again. They'll be like, we should just get married right now instead of wait a while.
Even though nothing has been resolved.
Yeah. Even though Emma's like, oh, we're going to wait a while before we even start planning. No, they're going to see each other again and we're going to be like, oh, everything is forgiven ever and ever and ever. And we shall get married immediately.
Even though nothing has changed.
Because it's going to be the musical episode.
Because that's dumb as shit. Why is everybody making musical episodes of things?
Oh yeah, we still need to watch the Flash.
Yeah.
Supergirl.
It's musical. Depressing. Stop it.
Yeah. So glad there was never a Smallville musical. So glad. I mean, there were millions of AUs, but...
Musicals are dumb.
Musicals are good whenever they're meant to be musicals. If it's
yes,
not a show,
yes,
with
musical
meant to
episodes
be a musical,
are dumb. And I don't mean episodes with music in them. I mean musical
episodes. But yeah, like Glee is good, but Glee is meant to be musical. Or at least, you know, the seasons that I've seen. I've seen like 2 seasons of it. But yeah. It keeps going unicorn ear-ish. I'm choking myself.
Don't do that.
I should not do that.
Don't do that.
But yeah.
It's a bad thing.
It is a very bad thing. But yeah, that's all my notes.
We hate this show.
Indeed. Was Belle in this episode at all? I don't believe.
I don't think she was.
I don't think she was.
I don't remember seeing her at all.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure she's not going to be coming back next season, even if there is a season 7. I don't know if she's in the finale. Because from what I hear, she's been in Los Angeles like this whole time they've been filming.
You know why?
Hmm.
Because she's like, fuck this show. This show's so stupid.
Anyway, so.
You know, since she's being hypocritical now and like fawning over Rumple again and how good Belle. He's being.
Belle, not Emily. Belle.
Yeah, Belle.
Just, you know, making it clear.
Yeah, Belle. Not Emily. Belle.
Yeah. God damn it,
Belle. I hate this show so much.
I hate this show. It has ruined my favorites, except for, you know, Rumple and Belle.
You assholes are the reasons that we keep doing this.
We love you.
Hate you.
Oh, that's not nice.
Now keep making me do this every, I'd say every week, but that wouldn't be true because we're on in the regular schedule since, you know, kids and stuff.
Yeah. I've been trying to keep it regular. This week and last week just got a little crazy, which you will see on Saturday. The video is uploaded and set to be posted. Yeah. So you will see why. Anyway, so we're gonna go. Thank y'all for watching. Press like if you like.
Watch more shit.
Subscribe.
Watch our stuff.
Press the little bell when you subscribe so you can get notifications.
Do the things.
You love us so much. Yes. And comment. Let us know what you thought of the episode. Let us know what you think of what's coming up. I don't know. I don't care. Comment potato if you get to this point.
No, like for real.
Like for real.
No, just comment potato.
Just comment potato because that was the first word that popped into my head. Ha ha. Anyway, and yeah, follow on Twitter and Facebook and Instagram and all that shenanigans. It's all down there. Anyway, bye. You gave me unicorn again.
It's your fault.
Bye, guys. Why did I press record?
Because you're so bad at this.
Like, I am so bad at
this. Holy crap.
Oh my God.